Tu as une chance à Montréal, au Québec, l'essence, tu sais, pas cher. Ça fait 11 mois quasiment au jour que je suis arrivé comme DG à Montréal. Le 2 mai, on est 3 septembre. 11 mois, ça passe vite.
24CH, the series, is brought to you by Bell. Watch 24CH on the screen of your choice.
April 3rd. The Canadians are in Philadelphia, baptized the city of brotherly love by its founder, William Penn. He imagined this place a haven for peace and tolerance. It is in this haven of peace that the team's recent acquisition from the LA Kings will play his first game as a Canadian.
Well, you're healthy for the most part?
Yeah, yeah.
Broke your nose, that was about
it. Yeah, it wasn't displaced or anything, so
nothing major.
Nothing really.
No issues
with that, yeah.
Good, so. Fantastic. All right,
okay.
Welcome aboard.
Thank you.
To meet you, pleasure.
Defenseman Davis Drewiski will be brought up to speed on the team's strategies during a morning meeting with coach Jean-Jacques Desnieux. The team may represent Philadelphia, but there is no brotherly love lost between the Flyers and their adversaries.
About 2 years ago, I walked up to my seat after the pregame warm-up. All the Flyer fans booed me, but good-naturedly, though. But yeah, I do feel a little out of place. But I'm proud of the Canadians. I wear my hat every arena I go to. I go to a lot of hockey games.
The relationship can, at best, be described as love-hate.
It is a little scary. I do admit it.
The Flyers' season hardly resembles the team's 1970s heyday, but their fans' devotion remains unconditional.
The best one's probably Giroux.
The Canadians begin their first game in Philadelphia in the same manner as they have so many others this season. By scoring the first goal.
Markov a remis derrière. Et là, c'est Pacioretty qui fait des vies à Yemeni de Tchirelemi!
Sometimes Lady Luck smiles upon us. Sometimes not. Despite the Flyers dominating the match, the Canadians jump on every opportunity. The third period, the Canadians still hold the lead, but the pressure from the Flyers is increasing.
Jeff, you got center with Prusty and Alex. Come on, let's get the next one. Let's get the next one. Let's go.
The shot totals tell the story. With less than 5 minutes left in the game, with two quick goals, their efforts are rewarded. Flyers have earned their victory. The loss is a bitter pill to swallow. For the players, obviously. But for the coaches as well. Even before leaving this haven of peace and brotherly love, Michel Therrien has moved past the defeat. He is already putting together his lines and pairings for his next match. Saturday, April 6th. The Canadians are back at the Bell Center. For these professional athletes, preparation is meticulous.
It was too hot, I wanted to cool it down. Hey, I wanted to cool it down.
Just done that.
See what he did? Put his thing in my right here, right here.
For nearly a century, the Habs have played the Bruins. Each confrontation has its own story to tell.
Came all the way from Boston to see them.
Brian Gionta. La dernière game, il en a pété deux pendant la game. J'en ai fait deux.
J'imagine que j'en fasse un autre aujourd'hui. Je sais pas si ça va y porter chance. J'espère. Si ça marche, je vais en faire à chaque game. Pas de problème avec ça.
Bam!
Yeah!
Imagine!
Oui, d'habitude, les gars, ils font ça de même. Gio, il me le demande pas. C'est une des premières fois qu'il me demande de faire ça.
Same thing. Do the right play. Keep the puck alive. Puck's gotta go this way. Keep the puck alive. Same thing. Different. Puck's ahead. Putting the pressure, same type of play. That's the difference.
It's the fourth meeting between these two teams this season. Once again, first place in the division is up for grabs. Boston has added a new card to their deck. Future Hall of Famer, Jaromir Jagr.
Ladies and gentlemen, accueillons nos Canadiens!
Michel Therrien's team won't allow itself to be impressed, nor will they be intimidated by a hungry adversary or by famous names. The air is thick with intensity, and the coaches are vehement with their instructions.
Hey, Chucky. On your forecheck, they go D to D all night, right? All night. So the puck goes over there, and then you're going on that post. That's not your job. It's the defenseman. They're going to go D to D. You either go for him, or you pull out, right? One of the two.
I pull out there, no?
Yeah, but you didn't even give yourself a chance. Like the puck, listen. Shut up and listen. We forechecked her here. The puck was over here. You came like this, and you went like that. This is your guy. So you either go to him, or you stay out. You know what I mean? Because you were doing the same thing as F1. It's no good.
Alex Galchenyuk is not one to feel sorry for himself.
Like I told you, you're working hard. You just got to work smart.
He reacts quickly to the new instructions, while adding his own personal touch. With the pendulum swinging in the Canadiens' favor, one brief moment brings it to a halt. Alexei Yemelin runs into a wall, Milan Lucic. Forced to leave the match as his worried teammates look on. For their part, the Bruins stick to their game plan. Part of that plan is targeting rookie Brendan Gallagher. But the Montreal Canadiens are as thick as thieves, and Francis Bouillon comes to the defense of his young teammate. The rookie can't help but show appreciation for a club which doesn't hesitate to have his back. During intermission, the coaches and players are all preoccupied with one person. Alexei Yemelin. The Russian defenseman has been a key to the team's success this season. The coaches realize the seriousness of the injury.
No, c'est son genou qui va là.
Yeah, I want to see it too.
Ouais, c'est ça. C'est ça. Tu sais, quand il y a un contact genou à genou, Juste ici. OK, vas-y. Arrête ici. Continue tranquillement. Il a contact ici, là, son genou gauche. Right there.
Okay.
Yeah. Is that where you at?
Yeah, that's neat. I don't know how bad it is, but it's bad.
It's,
he's going for an ACL,
right?
Probably.
So when he hit, didn't he buckle there?
Yeah.
It's a dramatic loss, but the Canadians carry on without number 74.
See, that breakout's not there when they regroup. That breakout's going to work when we go behind the net, but right there. Yes.
Michael Ryder will haunt his former team by deftly deflecting a shot. Once again, he's proven Marc Bergevin was right to bring him to Montreal, to the delight of his new coach. The Canadians are on a mission. They pursue the Bruins relentlessly. It seems obvious they will not stop until victory is guaranteed, to the great disgust of even the most loyal Bruins fans. Since losing their first meeting to the Bruins earlier in the year, the Canadiens have won their third consecutive game against their arch rival. There's another source of pride for Michel Therrien.
Galchenyuk!
The contributions of rookie Alex Galchenyuk. On the horizon, a visit from an Alex of a different sort, one with vastly more experience, one who intends to rule upon arriving in hockey's Mecca. The Capitals propel themselves into the Bell Center, riding a four-game winning streak. Their leader, Alexander Ovechkin, is on a tear. 16 goals and 8 assists in his past 14 games. When his team falls behind, he takes charge. In no time, fate smiles upon Washington, D.C.'s team captain. The Capitals are hunting for a playoff spot. They play with energy and desperation. They steal the victory. The coaches cannot become complacent. A trip to Buffalo 2 days later could be the gateway to a playoff berth for the 2013 edition of the Montreal Canadiens. The team is well aware of the weight one more victory will carry.
Alex Galchenyuk.
Pique Subban solidifies a playoff position with a bomb from the blue line. It's the exclamation point on a convincing 5-1 victory.
Ben voilà le Canadien qui remporte une 26e victoire, 57 points maintenant, et assure sa participation aux séries éliminatoires, mais se replace dans une situation avantageuse au classement de sa section et de l'association Est. Et il faudra dorénavant regarder les matchs qui restent, Marc, et l'évolution des adversaires également.
Qualifying this early in the season is an unheard of revival for a team which finished its previous season dead last in the Eastern Conference.
Perfect. Come on. One goal attained.
Every player and individual in the organization played a part in the team's success. It is a team accomplishment which is appreciated by general manager Marc Bergevin. To honor the moment, he makes a rare appearance in the players' locker room.
Hey, boys, listen up real quick. We'll be real quick. I'm really proud of what you guys have done so far this year. F***ing hat off to you guys. I swear to God, the way you compete from day one, I'm proud of you. This is one step. We got more ways to go, but I'm f***ing proud of you. Keep you up and keep f***ing going.
One team goal has been attained, but they won't stop there. From this point on, no team will give them the gift of an easy victory. Their opponents will want to prove they can go head-to-head with a playoff organization. The goaltenders and defensemen will have to hold down the fort. During their last meeting, the Canadiens bested the Leafs, taking revenge after their 6-0 loss. But they're still not done with their Canadian rival.
We have something to prove. We all remember what happened in Montreal, so we came here and we were ready to play that game, ready to play with an edge, because we were at, we had pride. Nothing different tonight. Okay? We still got something to prove to them. Let's make sure we focus about us, the way we can both capable to play. Like, focus on the way we're supposed to play. All right, boys, come on, let's go.
The Leafs have their own agenda. They have gone from the hunted to the hunter. Hockey is one sport where not so much as a single shot should be easily conceded to an adversary. With only 4 shots, the Leafs have scored 3 goals. The Habs swap goalies. It's that kind of night for those wearing the mask.
Il n'y a personne, mais l'intervention de Faneuf permet aux Leafs d'installer une attaque.
With a 4-goal deficit, talk of systems and discipline is replaced by instinct and warfare. Goaltender Carey Price acknowledges the situation at his first opportunity. The Leafs come away with an easy victory, this type of one-sided loss to an arch rival. Strikes at the pride of players and coaches. Hockey is a team sport. It's important for everyone to buy into that philosophy. But there is enormous pressure placed on the goaltender. For him, a lapse of judgment or the smallest error can result in a goal for the opponent. Therefore, Michel Therrien returns to his number one goaltender for the next match against the Philadelphia Flyers.
Et à la ligne bleue, un autre tir ennemi!
But the wound inflicted by the loss to the Leafs still has not healed. It's an untenable situation for a coach who is sensitive to the club's lethargy. Michel Therrien usually waits for the final moments of intermission before addressing his players.
I'm going there now.
Not this time.
This is bullshit. I'm f***ing professional the way you guys play. That f***ing attitude on top of it.
Speech reverberates with Brendan Gallagher, who ties the game. But the celebration is short-lived as the Flyers take advantage of an error and strike back. Quickly, the game gets out of reach. Despite not blaming him for the team's misfortune, Michel Therrien pulls Carey Price from his second consecutive game. As the Flyers' goals add up, the Bell Center's seats empty. In sports, everything is relative. In a hockey town like Montreal, fans begin to speculate on their team's first real crisis. Even after being guaranteed a playoff berth, Montrealers are not satiated. In the Montreal Canadiens' world, players and coaches cannot be allowed to wallow in defeat. The pressure is unparalleled.
Michel, comment t'expliques le manque d'intensité? Après deux périodes, vous aviez deux mises en échec seulement.
For Michel Therrien, his assistants, and his players, it is this adversity which builds a stronger team. Follow the conclusion of the Canadian season through the eyes of 24CH.